Hi, this is a satellite receiver model I-class 9595X. The problem with this device was that it created noise on the image and the device would lag suddenly. I opened the unit and replaced the damaged primary 400-volt capacitor. The device problem is solved. Now that I have opened the device, I would like to give you a brief explanation about common failure in satellite receivers. First, we examine the different sections together. This device consists of three main parts: power supply circuit section and voltage generation, the main circuit section, and the display section. First, we check the main voltages together to see what voltages must be present in the device for the circuit to work well. And if these voltages are not there, which part has a problem and what problem appears in the device. Most of the faults are related to the switching power supply, or we don't have voltage, either the voltage has dropped or fluctuated. In the main board section, often the voltage and current not reaching the main circuit blocks causes problem in the same section. In the display section, there is usually no special problem except from the failure of the function selection buttons. Let's start with the switching power section. At the entrance of the circuit, after checking that the wire and the main switch are healthy, we must check the fuse with the help of multimeter beep test. If we get a shock by touching the body of the device, these blue capacitors, which we also call Y capacitors, must be replaced. The switching part consists of two hot and cold parts. We don't touch the hot part with our hands because it gives us a shock. This yellow piece is a varistor. Its two pins should not be connected. When excess voltage enters, this component is connected and causes the fuse to be cut off and prevents further damage to the circuit. This black piece is NTC, which is a heat-sensitive resistor. This component prevents a sudden flux or current into the circuit. I am sure you know these components, so I will not explain more in this section. I will check these two pieces first. Varistor pins should not be connected. The NTC pins must be connected. In the next step, we check the capacitor in terms of appearance. If there was a problem, we should replace the capacitor. The biggest problem is related to changing the appearance of capacitor. They often swell. If the switching IC is burnt, it will cause a short circuit and the device will not turn on. After replacing the IC, be sure to replace its power supply capacitor as well. If the 400-volt capacitor has a problem, the image will be displayed with noise. In the output or cold section, there are several capacitors. If the capacitor or 1000 microfarad are damaged, the device will remain in boot mode. It is fixed on a red light, so to speak. Heat a capacitor with a hot air heater or soldering iron. If the problem is solved, replace the capacitors. The next capacitor corresponds to 24 volts. This voltage goes directly to the tuner. If this capacitor breaks, we will not receive any signal. There is an LM7805 regulator here, which is used to produce 5 volts. There is a transistor here. This transistor is rarely damaged, but it is better to check this transistor if the voltage does not reach the main board. Now, let's check the voltages of this section. The multimeter is in DC mode. I connect the black probe to the body of the device with the help of an alligator clip. I measure the outputs. Pay attention to the multimeter. Pin 3 is for control. When the device is off, it should have 3.3 volts. If we turn on the device, the voltage of pin 3 should be 0 volts. I turn the device on and off. Pay attention to the multimeter. The main board consists of several blocks. This is the CPU. This is RAM. This is the ROM memory. The same IC known as flash. This is the crystal. This is the LM317 regulator that provides the necessary voltages for the tuner. This is the tuner. A gate inverter IC is located here, which is used to control the LMIC. There is a regulator here that should supply the CPU and RAM voltage. Depending on the CPU model, this voltage can be 1.8 or 1.2. The flash IC receives 3.3 directly from the switching power supply. I measure the middle pin. The right pin is the regulator voltage input. A regulator is also under the tuner. I also measure this voltage. When we turn on the device, the information is first transferred to the RAM memory. So, if the RAM memory is damaged, the device will not start, or only the red light will stay on. These two capacitors are related to RAM. If these capacitors have a problem, the device will be fixed on the red light mode. Here is IC drain. If this IC is damaged, the device will automatically change the channel, or a security error is shown. It even displays an error related to chip replacement. If the capacitors placed next to the tuner have a problem, the horizontal and vertical mode is not activated and the device works in one direction. The switcher is not detected and the image will be seen with noise. The horizontal voltage is 13 volts and the vertical voltage is 18 volts. These voltages are created with the help of IC LM317. If the IC is damaged, the 13 and 18 voltages will not be made and we have a constant 24 volts in the tuner section. This is a crystal. A crystal is a mechanical piece that produces a frequency. If you dot this piece, give it a few gentle strokes. It's possible to rework it. If the crystal is damaged, the device will not turn on, or the picture will be black and white, or the device will not be able to search and scan channels. The value of this crystal is 27 MHz. A covalent crystal must be replaced. Next to the crystal, there is an IC with the prefix LCX. This IC adjusts the circuit related to the LM regulator. If this IC is damaged, the LM regulator will not be able to regulate the voltage of 18 and 13. This yellow piece is the fuse. Part number F100. If the LMB wire are connected together, this fuse is cut off. If your device has a good signal and the quality of the signal is good, but it is not able to receive the channels, the failure of the tuner can be the reason. There are several capacitors on top of the CPU. If this capacitor is damaged, the image becomes dark or black and white. First, heat the capacitors with a hot air heater. If the problem is solved, replace the capacitors. If the settings are lost after scanning the channels and turning off the device, there is a problem with IC flash. You should program the IC. If the problem of the device is not solved by programming the IC, replace the IC. IC programming is very simple, and we can often do this without any problems. Be sure to use the right program. It is very easy to find damaged transistor with a multimeter. So, if you have the voltages, but there are still problems, check the transistors. Finally, I remind you to always double-check the soldered components and that the components are correctly connected on the PCB. Thank you for watching this video.